गुरुभ्यो नमः। स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेसन नंबर 5 एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल। आवर लेसन नंबर 5 इज अडैप्टेशंस इन एनिमल्स। नाउ चिल्ड्रन, व्हाट डू यू सी इन द पिक्चर? यस, यू सी अ कैक्टस। इट इज अ कैक्टस प्लांट। Now, where does it mainly grow? In a desert where less water is available. Same way, the next picture is of a lotus. And you can see a lotus plant. It will be always in water. It is able to survive in water. So, both the plants have features to survive in their habitat. So, these special features shown by a plant is called as adaptations. Animals are seen all around us in different surroundings. They survive on land, sea and air. They are found on mountains, forests, deserts, polar areas, oceans, seas, rivers, etc. The natural home or environment of an animal is called its habitat. Now, the changes or modifications in the animal bodies to suit their immediate surroundings are called as adaptation. Now, let us learn more about adaptations in animals on the basis of their habitat. Depending on their environment in which the animals live, they can be classified into aquatic animals, terrestrial animals, amphibians and aerial animals. So children, let's start. So the first one we are going to learn is about aquatic animals. In your previous classes also, children, you have learnt about aquatic animals. These are the animals that live in water. Now, aquatic animals, they have special structures to move easily in water, to breathe in water and to prevent water from being absorbed into their bodies. Now, let's see how aquatic animals gets adapted to its environment. A fish has a streamlined body shape. It helps the fish to move easily in water. Now, children, tell me, what do you mean by the word streamlined body? It means the fish body is like a shape of a boat and it helps the fish to move easily in the water. If you see the picture, you can see it is broad in between and narrow at both the ends. That is why we call it as streamlined body. The tail helps in changing the direction. A fish breathes with the help of its gills. It takes in oxygen dissolved in the water. Whales and dolphins have lungs for breathing. Now children, whales and dolphins, they have blowholes located near the top of the head, which helps them to inhale air from the surface above the water. Now children, let's talk about the locomotor organs in these aquatic animals. Before that, let's see what are locomotor organs. Organs that help an animal to move from one place to another are called as locomotor organs. So children, tell me, what are the locomotor organs in a fish? The fins. Yes, the fins help the fish to swim and balance itself in the water. Starfish, they have tube feet. Can you see the picture, children? Can you see those white small tubes? They are the locomotor organs for the starfish. Ducks have webbed feet. Turtles have paddle-like limbs. Yes, children. So these are the locomotor organs of fish, starfish, duck and turtles. The soft bodies of fish are protected by scales. So, why are they protected by scales, children? The scales are waterproof and they do not allow water to come in contact with the skin. Clear, children? So the scales are going to protect the body of a fish. Children, the second type of animals we are going to learn is aerial animals. Now, what are aerial animals? The animals that can fly are called as aerial animals, or in short we call them as birds. Examples are crow, pigeons, sparrow, parrots, eagles, woodpeckers, and so on. Now, these aerial animals, they have special structures like wings. They have wings to fly. They have body feathers. Can you see the picture, children? Each bird have feathers on them. And their body is light and hollow. Now, let's see how these aerial animals, they get adapted to its environment. All birds have beaks. The beak is an adaptation to suit the feeding habits of birds. Now, children, I hope you all know what is a beak. It is a hard pointed part of a bird's mouth, and the shape and the color, it differs from bird to bird. Now, birds have hollow bones and light boat shaped bodies to help them fly in the air. Now, children, the hollow bones and the boat shaped body of a bird helps it to fly. Now, their wings have strong muscles to help them fly. The body of bird is covered by feathers, and there are three types of feathers: soft down feathers, flight feathers, and tail feathers. So the first one, soft down feathers, it keeps them warm, and flight feathers, it helps the bird to fly. Tail feathers, it helps them to control the direction of the flight. Now, children, can you name an aerial animal which does not have any feathers on its wings but it can fly? Yes, the answer is bat. The bat, it does not have any feathers on its wings. The wings are made of thin layers of skin, and these are stretched across the arms and fingers. Now, children, let's talk about amphibians. What do you mean by amphibians? These animals are adapted to live both in water and on land. Yes, children, animals that are adapted to live both in water and on land are called as amphibians. Example, frog, toad, and salamanders. Now, children, let's see how these amphibians are adapted to their environment. Amphibians use their limbs for movement both in water and on land. They have short front legs which keeps the front part of the animal's body off the ground, and longer hind legs which allows them to jump with ease. They also have webbed feet to swim in the water. Children, adaptation of amphibians continues. Amphibians breathe through lungs on land and through skin or gills in water. So, children, can you see the picture? You can see the frog breathing through its lungs. Now, if the frog is breathing through its skin, it is called as cutaneous breathing. Breathing through skin is called cutaneous breathing. Now, children, there is a special feature in these amphibians. Let's talk about them. Apart from their regular eyelids, some amphibians such as frogs have a transparent third eyelid called nictitating membrane. Now, what is this nictitating membrane? It is a whitish or a translucent membrane that forms an inner eyelet in these animals. And how does it help these amphibians? These third eyelet, it prevents water from entering into their eyes and allows them to see underwater. And it also protects the eye from dust and it keeps it moist. Now children, we will talk about terrestrial animals in the next module. And now we shall wind up this module by learning these key points. Habitat. The natural home or environment of an animal is called its habitat. Adaptation. The changes or modifications in the bodies of animals to suit their immediate surroundings are called as adaptation. Cutaneous breathing. Breathing through skin is called cutaneous breathing. Nictitating membrane. The transparent third eyelid in amphibians is called as nictitating membrane. And streamlined, it means broad in between, in the middle and narrow at both ends, like a boat. Children, it's your activity time. You have to identify the pictures, write on which animals they are found and how they help them. Yes, children. So, children, again watch this module. Read through your ebook also. So, children, we will meet in the next module. Till then, keep smiling and stay safe. Thank you.